On their way to the Rose Bowl, Penn State came in here as the number one team in the country, but they left an undisputed number two. Penn State was running away with the ball game thanks to Kerry Collins, Kajana Carter, and company, and then came Chris Ditto late and a couple of late touchdown passes by the Hoosiers, including a two-point conversion as the final play of the ball game, and it was only a six-point difference. There went the top ranking. There went the national title. Penn State comes in here today. They're still in the top 20, but nowhere near where they were about a month ago. Hi, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler with Gary Danielson. A month ago, Gary, this was the number three team in the country. Joe Paterno told us then we're not that good. Well, I guess they've proven they aren't that good. They're 6-2 now, and they're searching a little bit.
They are searching, and if you talk to them, they're not feeling good about how they feel and about their team right now, losing last week to Iowa. And the problem I think they're having is not enough big plays, not enough weapons for Wally Richardson to use. But you know, last week they may have found another guy, another weapon. It's a fullback, Aaron Harris, and it's a little different for a Penn State offense who so long have really gone with a fullback who blocks. Now they've got a guy, another weapon to go along with Curtis Enos, who can give Wally Richardson a little.
A Hoosier football team that's lost its last 12 conference games would be content just to get through today's game and then finish off their final three. Well, think again. Head coach Bill Mallory and his team leaders are a very tight group. They fully realize that Penn State is no longer a dominant team. They also realize that they are practically just the spot of a ball away from beating the Wolverines last week. Today for the Hoosiers, it goes beyond waiting for some other guy on the team to make a big play or waiting for something to go wrong. The Hoosiers fully expect to beat Penn State today, Brad.
Michigan, the worst they had all day was 2nd and 11. So far, they've started off well.
Here's another bootleg. Rodgers rifles it. It's intercepted by Collins. Collins last year had an 80-yard touchdown on his first career interception. Well, here in series number one, he's got the pickoff for Penn State.
Third down, fourth down at a field goal situation. Brett Conway will try from 37 yards away. And he's got it right down the middle for our first score of the ball game. So the Aaron Collins interception does net Penn State 3 points. They lead by a field goal.
Return.
They would have been in a lot better shape without that penalty. Quick snap again. Here's the play action bootleg. That pass tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Sean Lee. Conway against Temple hit a 52-yarder, his career long. This is a 49-yard field goal attempt, and it's blocked. Damian Gregory, I think, is the guy that got a hand on it. Indiana takes over at midfield. Second and goal just outside the four.
Just a passing down.
Here comes the option. He'll keep there. That's goal. Down a yard for Indiana. Smith got 9. And now the man that took his spot, Jason Spear, down the sideline. Second down at 4. Nice play fake bootleg. Toss it out there to the tight end. And he's got a first down to the 31-yard. Third down and a long 10.
Could do that quarterback draw again, too.
Here comes the pressure on it. He's going to float one out for Smith, who made a nice catch and now trying to get around the linebacker, and he did. Alex Smith got a first down.
Wow.
Wow. He had to get around Filardi and then had to keep his balance, and he did. First down, Indiana.
The holder, they have faked some field goals this year. This one spotted down, though, and the man they call Mano has got it up and in. Manolopoulos tacks on 3 more.
After Hutt, third down at 15. Quick snap this time. Deep ball, man open. Jurevicius has got it. He'll have a touchdown. Those two hooked up last year against Indiana for a 55-yard score. This one goes 57.
He's in right now trying to keep him fresh in a long game.
Extra receivers in two for Indiana. Thinking about a quarterback draw and weaves his way. First down, Rodgers. Rodgers. Long handoff, Alex Smith again. Smith into the secondary, one man to beat. All the way to the 17-yard line. Shino Prater saved a touchdown.
On the day now.
And here comes his replacement. Spear, touchdown. First down here. They'd like to add to their lead if they could. Another end around coming to Jamu Stoner with Rodgers. The quarterback trying to lead the way. Oh, tripped up.
Blocking that time by Petalius.
The throw complete. Down the sideline of the 16 goes Versi Gaddis.
They'll put this one down. They try a 28-yard field goal. Manolopoulos has three more. Let her rip.
As the half closes, it's been a blast so far if you're an Indiana fan. We've played two quarters, and the Hoosiers on their feet. They lead 20-10 at halftime. Shorter kick this time. Watson from the two. Watson, big seam right up the middle. Kenny Watson cuts outside across the 40 all the way to midfield and then some. That's the way you start the third quarter when you're trailing. A 53-yard kickoff return by Kenny Watson. 44-yard field goal attempt by Brett Conway. He's a good kicker. He's already shown that today. And he's got it. Another three for Penn State with plenty to spare. The would-be reception. Second down and 10. Give it off. Eberle. First down run for Eberle. You could write patience as a virtue. His arms are so big. McQueary. And now he's going to air it near side. Joe King's out there and he's got it. Intercepted.
That was Mark Thiel jumping up and down there.
Here comes a post pattern. Jurevicius has it. To the 10. Jurevicius getting all the way to the 10. Eberle hitting the backfield. Bounces off, and Eberle somehow still on his feet inside the 5. What a run.
Goes, he'll be the motion man outside the 3.
Play action. Loft it to the end zone. Touchdown, Penn State. They're a point away from tying it up. It's Eberle who did a lot of the work on that sensational run to get him close. Now as a pass receiver, he's got him in the end zone. Third down and a long 8. This is the kind of spot you get a little bit nervous. Here comes a blitz on McQueary. He's going to throw it for Jurevicius, and he got him again. Might be a face mask on Eric Allen at the end of the play, which is going to set Penn State up first and goal. First and goal for the Nittany Lions. Nastassi in motion. Two tight end set. The give, Choppy Fields. He is close. He's in. Touchdown. Dragon Warnicke with him. Third down and a long 5. Rodgers, look out. Twisted in half. Did he lose the ball as well? They're going to blow it dead at the 16. That ball did come out. Snyder with a big hit.
I think that guy has seen this before, don't you think?
I think he has.
He goes, not again.
They fake it to Eberle. McQueary comes up going deep for Jurevicius. Another one he pulls down at the 10.
Holy cow. Jurevicius is having an outstanding game.
Only averaging 39 a catch. Second and goal. Counter, Eberle hitting the backfield and score.
That's the second time that Eberle has made a play from the backfield that has been huge in the second half of this game.
24 unanswered Penn State points. They lead by 2 touchdowns. In the second half here for Penn
State,
he has been a force to be reckoned with on offense. McQueary rolls, wants to throw, waits for Jurevicius to come open and then skipped it off his hands. Penn State forced to punt. Jamu Stoner waiting on the punt. Oh, fumble it. Penn State's got it. Second down and 5. Bouncing outside. Harris for the touchdown. Penn State points.
Who has seen his team battle valiantly against the competition this year, and at many times looked like they had him where they wanted him, but second half collapses have killed this Indiana team this year. Today's not going to be an exception. High snap from the shotgun. Rodgers throws. It's intercepted. Spilotti. Touchdown, Penn State.
goes 27 yards for the score. Penn State had to fight for it, but fight for it they did, and they're going to get the victory, 48-26. Stay tuned. The Residence Inn scoreboard shows next. For Gary Danielson, Adrian Carson, and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Brad Nessler. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. From Bloomington, we'll see you next week. Now let's check in with Mike Tirico on the Residence Inn College Scoreboard Show. Michael, it's all yours. All right, guys.